Was this your first ever debate?
Yeah.
How'd it go? Yeah. How'd it feel?
Well, how did it look like it felt? Yeah. That's a tough situation, and I'm going to practice up on elbowing my way.
We need to do more than small random acts of kindness. We need huge strategized acts of doing the right thing. Look at terrorism. We know that what hate, how powerful it is when it is turned into a political force, but it's nothing compared to how powerful love is when it's turned into a political force.
Although the Republicans don't walk their talk, the Democrats are not that good sometimes at talking their walk.
First issue that you're going to push, you get one shot that it may be the only thing you get past. What is that first issue? And Ms. Williamson with the last
call. My first call is to Prime Minister of New Zealand, who said that her goal is to make New Zealand the place where it's the best place in the world for a child to grow up. And I will tell her, girlfriend, you are so on, because the United States of America is going to be the best place in the world for a child to grow up.
Ms. Williamson,
we are going
thank you guys.
Ms. Williamson, we've been talking a lot about access to health insurance, but for many Americans, their most pressing concern is the high cost of health care. How would you lower the cost of prescription drugs?
Well, first of all, the government should never have made the deal with the big pharma that they couldn't negotiate. That was just part of the regular corruption by which multinational corporations have their way with us. I'll tell you one thing. It's really nice that we've got all these plans, but if you think we're going to beat Donald Trump by just having all these plans, you've got another thing coming. Because he didn't win by saying he had a plan. He won by simply saying, make America great again.
What are some concrete steps you plan on taking to translate your emotionally based or abstract based campaign into real world success?
I'm not just a philosopher. I am someone whose work, having founded AIDS organizations, having founded peace organizations, and having worked on anti-poverty efforts throughout my adult career. I'm a very practical woman. I don't just talk. You don't see me in cut velvet. You know, I'm not just pink paint and crystals. I'm into getting things done. I'm going to harness love for political purposes. I will meet you on that field, and sir, love will win.
We need to purify the heart of a nation, just like we need to purify our own hearts. And then when we do that, when we're honest about the darkness we need to deal with, we will get to such incredible light, and we will have a new birth of freedom.
Does it say that Fox News is nicer to me than the lefties are?
I'm sorry?
What does it say? That the conservatives are nicer to me.
It's a bizarre world, man.
It's such a bizarre world.